Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video I will be assembling the third build from the LEGO Creator Set 31135, which is the Super Fuel Dragster. But before we go on to that, I would like to welcome a couple of new subscribers. We have Nu Thai Ha, that's at one of them, and Eka Tep Nha KP Bohok. I hope I pronounced that right. Thank you very much for subscribing the channel and supporting. If you'd like a shout out on this channel, all you have to do is like, share or subscribe, or leave a kind or constructive comment at the end of the video. And if you do that, you are pretty much guaranteed a shout out as well. But we will get on with the build now. So this is the box it comes in. As you can see, we're building that one down there, which is the third build, which is going to be the built from the bits from this one here, which is the vintage motorcycle. It does look quite good on the back of the box when they've done all the good background art on it like that. You get the instruction manual. It doesn't look too bad on here, to be honest with you. The motorbikes don't look, the motorbike ones do look a bit blocky, but this one does look quite good, to be honest with you, for what it is. If it was three dragsters, you'd probably go, no, it doesn't look right, but this one does look quite good. It's a bit thinner as well, but this is what you get with these three-in-one builds. Someone builds the vintage motorcycle and they go, what? We need two other builds because we can't sell that. Lego don't want to sell a sort of vintage motorcycle. They want to sell these three-in-one sets, give you lots of three different builds to do, and you learn lots of good building techniques as well. Without further ado, I will stop talking and start building. We start off with a black 3x2 base plate, like so. Have a grey 5x1 base plate, another grey 5x1 base plate goes on top, like so. Then we have a green 2x2 round base plate. Then a purple 2x2 base plate. They go on like that. Now we build what looks like could be the front or the rear. I'm going to take a guess at the rear axle, I think, but I will probably be wrong. So we start off with a grey 2x1 brick with two Technic connector holes in. Two of the green four axles with the molded end on them. I'm trying to find them now. So these Technic four axles have got like a flat end on them so they can go straight in and hold there. They got two more of these grey 2x1 bricks with a hole in them. One, two. They go on like that. You got two of these black right angle connector pieces, which is, so you got a cross connector on one piece and you got a round connector on the top. They go on the top like that. You've got a black six axle, which goes on like that, with two Technic grey spacers. Goes on like that. And that goes on there. You've got two of these grey 2x1 base plates with a 4x2 studded plate on moulded onto this side. So these go on like so. Now we've got the green Technic 2x1 brick with the Technic thin bits that go on there like that. I have a black Technic 2 axle and two of the Technic thin plates like so. These go in the middle like that and get pushed through. Like so. You've got a green 6x2 base plate which goes on top like this, with two of these purple 4x2 plates with the curved edges. Curved ends, I should say. They go on like that. Then you have a grey 2x2 upside down curved roofing piece which goes on the back there like that. I put the front wheels on and they have a yellow 3-axle with a grey thin spacer, then a grey wheel or pulley wheel. Goes on there like that. Then you have another grey pulley wheel goes on the other side with a grey thin Technic spacer. They go on there like that. And that is the front wheels for the Super Fuel dragster. That over, then you have a purple 2x2 curved roofing piece, a purple 2x2 base plate, and a purple 2x1 plate with a stud in the middle. Goes on there on the top like that. Then you have a black double cheese piece. So one thing I would recommend in hindsight is to actually make sure you actually make sure you separate the pieces into colours, because it makes stuff easier to find afterwards. I haven't done that, and I'm struggling to see the pieces I actually need. So there we go. So there it is. Then we have a grey two grey 2x1 base plates, half one flat. One studded and one with a female C connector on it. That goes on there like that. We're over halfway with this build, so the third build is always a bit more on the simpler side. We've got a grey 2x2 right angled base plate. And we've got a green 2x1 curved end base plate. Goes on there like that. With two what I call black silencer pieces, or they can be used as exhaust, I suppose. We call them exhaust pieces just to not upset people. Now we make the spoiler for the vehicle. And that starts off as a black thin Technic plate, four Technic plate of a yellow three axle, goes on one end like that. You have what looks like a cream Technic half connector, so it goes in there like that and that. And you've got one of these pieces here, which is a Technic two-hole piece with a angled pole piece on it. That goes on there like that. Then you put another one of those on there, exactly the same, with a cream You have to see that other half spacer in there, because it should be in there. Then you have another black four thin connector bar. Goes on there like that. Two of these black robot arm pieces. These ones here. They've got a male round bar on there. Goes on the back there, so for the spoiler. And then you've got two of these big wheels to go on the back here. Have the Super Fuel Dragster. It's a nice little build for what it is. It looks like one of the it looks like one of the a racing. You could probably modify it into a racing wheelchair a bit better, I think, to be honest with you. One of those ground level bikes or something. I think it probably could work better as one of them as well. But overall, it's not a bad little build for what you've got. Obviously, someone at LEGO has struggled to put anything together with the With the bits that were left, or if you get something that actually fits within the brand. These wheels at the front don't have as much movement as I would like. Let's have a look. The wheels at the front aren't great, as you can see, because you can't whiz it along. It's probably better on carpet or something like that, but it works slightly better. But it's not a bad little build for what it is, really, though. You can't really overly object to it, really. So there is much more, not much to say about this. This is the third build, so you're not expecting too many. You're not expecting too much from it. And they have managed to put. I mean, the vintage motorcycle does look good, but this is not the best build of the set. But you're not expecting it to be. And if you put a Lego head in it, you could pretend someone's racing it as well. We could just rebuild it slightly bigger as well. You shouldn't rebuild it what you got here, but you just get some more bricks and rebuild it slightly bigger, and you've got a nice little Lego dragster as well. So it's not too bad. It's got the exhaust bits on the back. It does what it's meant to do. It's a cheap 3-in-1 set, and you've got a nice little build on it as well. I do quite like this build. It does appeal to me. The more I look at it, it does look good for what it is. Shame you couldn't do a bit more with these wheels on the front, which is the only thing that it lets it down a little bit. But like you say, it's a £9 bit. It's a bottom end Lego creator set, and you're not expecting a lot from it, though. You're not expecting it to be the best Lego set you've ever brought, but it's enjoyable, and it is good for what it is for the third build. I will be trying a custom build from the spare parts I have here when I've done this video, and I will be posting the video. So do keep an eye out for that one, because I'm not sure what I'm going to build with this, but at some point I will be curing the music, if anyone of a certain age will know what I mean, and I will be trying to build something with the spare parts. I'm struggling a bit what I'm going to build, but it will be something. So hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, do feel free to like, share and subscribe. I'm on YouTube, Instagram and Threads. I'm also on TikTok as Toyman Stu at the moment, which is a new channel I'm just doing on TikTok. I might be doing a few more toy stuff on here in the near future, and moving everything over to Toyman Stu at some point. But at the moment, Lego Man Stu is here to stay until I can work out exactly what I'm doing with Toyman Stu, and whether the TikTok thing takes off as well. So again, hope you enjoyed this video. Like I say, like, share, subscribe. If you would like a shout out on one of my videos, all you have to do is subscribe, like, share, subscribe, or leave a kind or constructive comment on one of my videos, and I will give you a shout out. Stay safe, keep building, and hope to see you in an upcoming video. Thank you for watching.